Hello everybody and welcome to a new video. Yes, it's time to do Grid, the new game. Well, it still has a bit of a look of the older versions that have been released already on the 360, PlayStation 3, PC, whatever. But this is the new one and you know what? I kind of liked it. As a matter of fact, yesterday when I bought the game, I started to play and after like the introduction races, I thought, you know what? I'm going to make a video on my first few races and how I liked the game. And as you can see, I couldn't stop playing, except for when you have to go eat and do your things that you need to do in a home, clean up and get ready, and then back to the game. And so I thought, you know what, instead of uploading that video, I'm going to do a kind of a review. Of course, I am still not that far into the game, but yes, I've been tinkering with the settings, I've been doing a lot of stuff, and you know what, I truly love this game, and I thought, you know, I'm going to do a new video, so let's go. I'm starting from the beginning instead of continuing because I do not want to spoil anything for if you haven't decided on buying the game yet, which you should. Okay. Well, as you can see, when you select a car, you get some options like livery. You can sell the car that you've bought if you prefer getting another car. But I'm sticking with this one. What I like most about the game is, and that's with every game, the gameplay somehow grips me. How the cars respond. You have five different settings on each category. Well, let's turn down the sound a bit. That's better. So, where did I left off? After I shocked that the volume was a bit high because I was watching a movie before I am gaming, and somehow the volume of a movie is lower than that of a game. But back to the game, and here you get some more choices. I prefer to do the hot lap qualifying first, so especially if you're new to the game and you don't memorize all the tracks yet, because in this game there are real-life tracks and fantasy tracks alike, mixed together. And due to the arcade-like graphics and gameplay, I kind of like this game more than Forza now, in the beginning, especially until Forza Horizon 4. That was my favorite game, but somehow, I don't know what it is, gameplay or, well, let's just dive into the whole qualifying lap. Somehow this game grips me even more. What I like, but it's not necessary, is that, for instance, your car doesn't look like it's just being released from the showroom. It really looks like a car that has been used several times and only being cleaned, and but still the rubber and some paint damage that is still visible. It gives the game a bit more a rugged, used look instead of driving some show cars around. Oh, now I remember what I was talking about. You have five different settings for each thing, like the traction control, stability control. And in the beginning I had them at max, because that was the default setting. And when I started playing those introduction levels, I was like, I felt I was being helped too much. I like to feel how the car responds on heavy accelerating. The only thing that I still got on max is the anti-lock system for the brakes. Because, well, most modern cars have that built in already, so I don't see this as a helping aid, but it's like a modern way to make the cars safer. But I truly like that extra feeling that you get if you have to catch when you accelerate too hard. Yes, that was a first place qualifying. What I also like is, now the race starts, there's a guy and a woman talking about the race introduction. When you are not impatient, then you just say, well, let's continue, and then they start talking. And when it's ready, they say the race is starting. But me, I'm impatient, I want to race now. And then say, oh, wait a minute, I see the race is about to start. So let's go. So when she is talking about some things, about the drivers or the track conditions or something, he breaks her up when you interrupt the starting flow where the camera pans over the cars. And then he says, no, wait, the race is about to start. And also when you drive past some speakers, you will hear them talking about the race. When you bump into somebody, you get to hear sometimes that there has been some paint trading, something like that. It makes the game more alive, where Forza is looking perfect, but is very clinical, so to speak, like in a hospital. Everything is nice and clean, as the grass has been done with a comb, so everything is sticking in the right direction. This game is more, like I said, with the paint, it's been used, it's not too clean. And well, this game starts off with a normal circuit track, which looks very nice, but me, I prefer the tracks that are based in a city. Why? Then the public is much closer to you and they also react to how you drive. For instance, if you lost control of your car and you bump into the side, you see them flinch. They back off of the board where they're standing behind. They really get shocked if you crash into that. And this, combined with a lot of 3D public, so not cardboard cutouts, no, it's true, 3D graphics. And then it struck me. The gameplay, the kind of graphics, the design, it reminded me of another game where I had so much fun about, but we never got to see a sequel anymore. Project Gotham Racing. Oh man, I had so much fun with that game. Of course, it started with the Dreamcast version. It had a different name. I kind of forgotten the... It was Project Gotham Racing. PTR, whatever. I don't know anymore, but I have the game on the Dreamcast. But when it started to come to the normal Xbox, and then the 360 with PGR 3, and 4, oh man, those were the games, especially 4, that looked like a new generation game while it was still running on the 360. For instance, PGR 3 had a lower resolution, the frame rate was lower, but it still was amazing because you had a lot of, well, first of all, of course, the gameplay, but you had a lot of public also in 3D. Yeah, like this game, it really felt true. And if you still use Google today and you compare like PGR locations with real life, you can see they really did their best to get the game looking like you drive through the real cities that are featured in the game. And somehow this game gives me the same feeling. But of course, this is being, of course, a newer generation than the 360. You get even more details in the buildings, the windows and the doors. They are no longer only painted or photographed of doors and windows. And so you get to see really bumps and things sticking out and so much more detail in it. And what is also nice and surprising, that just like with the Forza series, the frame rate is 60 frames per second and the resolution is 4K. Well, at least it is on the console I'm playing on, the Xbox One X. Oh man, I want to say as you can see, but you haven't seen the first video. In the first video, I still had to get the feeling of the game. So I was swerving all over the place on some points in the tracks, but right now, I can talk and drive at the same time. I would drive better if I wasn't talking, but then it would have been like a game capture of the game and not my opinion of the game and how I'm experiencing the game. It's still, when I will turn off the camera, I don't even want to video edit the video, put it like the Xbox One X in the top left corner and so. I want to just continue playing, but you know what, it's nice to upload a new video for my gaming channel once in a while as well. I've been neglecting, due to the lack of time, my music channel as well. Sorry. But yeah, you have 24 hours in a day and you can only spend them once. So you have to make choices. Let's do another qualifying lap. So you can skip the qualifying lap, but then you start from last place. Just like with all these arcade races, and yeah, I know, also in Forza, the things on the side on the road are animated. So like the carnival on the ground of the track. Also, just like Forza, this game has different weather types. But unlike Forza, especially the newest Forza, well, the newest I'm talking about, Forza 7, that has a weather that can change in the race. Well, here it's either dry or rain. It's not that you start on a dry track and then it gets overcast and then you get some rain. So from that technical viewpoint, Forza 7 is better than this game. Like, as you can see, you get fireworks when you finish either a race or, in this case, a time trial. Yeah, it gives a bit more of that arcadey feeling. And I also like the color scheme. Some colors really are exaggerated. They pop out of the screen. And, of course, I guess also on the PlayStation 4 Pro, this game supports high dynamic range. It really makes a difference. Yeah, let's go.
Well, we're about to see how this all plays out, so don't go anywhere.
Yeah, I didn't interrupt the guy, so after don't go anywhere, the race starts. So if I remember the next time, I will interrupt them quicker, so maybe he gets to make some comment on the race starting. What I also noticed, just when I went through the last corner, or previous corner, that you get some brown mud in between the grass. Let me see if I can hug the racing line. Oh yeah, like points for driving a clean section, don't bump. Well, I didn't went on the racing line this time, but you get more points or more money if you finish the race. If you've done somewhere, and this is also what reminds me on Pro Evolution Platform Racing, in PGR for short. And that is like the kudos systems, but here it's being turned around in money. So for me, more useful, so you can buy newer cars more quicker in a row. Look, I get a times 2 bonus. I guess I did the racing lines very nice and another clean section on the track. And there are also cars that are better for, suited for drifting, so you get points for drifting. So yeah, so you can imagine why it feels like PGR to me. You get rewarded for showboating, so to speak, or a hooligan. You always know that you are driving the last race and crossing the finish line, because you get to see all those colored papers being thrown in the air and the fireworks and another race down the line. And let's skip. Level up, so you get some more bonuses, more money, and sometimes you unlock more livery because you can change the car's livery. I haven't dived into it too much. So what I did, I choose a nice design and change the color scheme. I don't know if, like Forza, you can really create your own decals and place the sponsored names on places where you want them to be. So I haven't checked that out yet, but even if it's not the case, I don't mind, because, well, this is more like an arcade type of racer. And still, for an arcade type racer, you get a lot of different choices. Well, this is a one car that I've changed. So this is one where I've changed the color scheme. and choose a different linings with the, now you got flames on the side, and otherwise it had like a more basic things like this. Okay, back to the car and let's give it a go. Bay Arena Storm. Oh, don't forget, I need to that is only with the race, not with the time trial. With the time trial, they are not going to talk. You just immediately start the time trial.
What an iconic setting here today, Kristen. From Alcatraz all the way to Fisherman's Wharf, San Francisco is primed to host this.
Yes, this looks awesome, man. I really like this. Some people are leaning forwards too much. The arms are over the barriers. Whoa, almost drifting. You can really feel the difference between a rear-wheel drive car or four-wheel or front-wheel drive. And usually with a racing game that's based more on arcade handling, you get a feel a bit different, but you cannot feel if it's rear or front-wheel drive. But yeah, nice. As you can see, the public around the track, they are animated very smoothly. It really gives you the vibe of driving in a race, in a city. I mean, in a race, yeah. When you're racing in a racing game, of course you're in a race. So ease off the accelerator when the car starts to slide too much. And back on the throttle, go. Also, something that I noticed is somehow I found the car sounds more realistic in an arcade game like this, or there are other arcade type drivers that has good sound. Then for instance on Forza, a lot of cars, that they give me the idea of them driving a vacuum cleaner. Why? Why does the car sound more powerful in an arcade type race game than on games like Forza or Gran Turismo? But to be honest, I haven't played Gran Turismo for a long time, even though I have Gran Turismo Sport on the PlayStation 4 Pro. Okay, let's continue. And when I start the race, I will skip the chatting and let's see what he says. I don't know if the microphone will pick it up, but...
Hello, and thank you for joining us here in today's Grid World Series event. It looks like the race is about to start.
Yeah, I was so quick that you couldn't even hear the girl starting because he was still announcing. But he did say indeed, like, oh, it looks like the race is about to start. It's nice that that you get to see some pop of the shadow from the building from behind. Well, other than that, there's no real pop-up in the scenery itself, or that you get for in case of GTA, that you get to see some people popping up halfway through the screen. Here, the public, everything that's on the screen is there already from the start. The only thing that gets applied halfway sometimes are some textures, or what you just recently saw, the shadow being popped into the wall. Oh, too much throttle. Go, relax. But I got some points as a small drift. Also, when you drive over curbstones, you're gonna ease off the throttle. Oh man, I was too fast there. But otherwise your car will spin around. Yes, you can also make the settings so you don't have to do this. You can set, like I said in the beginning of the review, you can change the driving aids, like the stability or traction control, from 1 to 5. So and 1, the lower setting, you don't get any help. And on the highest setting, it really feels like an arcade game where you almost, it's impossible to crash unless you're really not good at steering your car in the right direction. But like I said, for me it's more fulfilling if you have to do a bit more than just point where you want the car to go. the graphics and the mood of the game, that makes me want to play, that makes me want to continue. And for me, that's a sign of a good game. Take for instance GTA, what I was just talking about. That's a very old game. I got it for the 360, I got it for the Xbox One, I got it for the PlayStation 4, and I got it for the PC recently when I bought myself this new PC so I could video edit in 4K. So that is also an amazing game that I can play again and again and again. That can be online, that can be the story mode. This game has that same feeling. I know for sure that even like years from now, I will still be getting this game out of the cupboard once in a while and still play it. Some other racing games, they are too generic, and then, well, after a while you start to forget about them. But I don't think this is one of them. When Grid was backwards compatible, the 360 version on the Xbox One, I also started playing the game again. But this newer game, of course, yeah, this shows what the newer systems can do. Yeah, I'm not a Digital Foundry type of guy. I do not have the means to show you that in so much quality. And due to time lag, I don't feel like using the game capture stuff you can do on the Xbox One X, because you cannot record your voice. Then have to record that separately, and well, it takes a lot more time. Time that I don't have. And so I'm videotaping my games the lazy way. I just aim my 4K webcam to the TV. There's also a microphone in there. I use some video audio capturing software, and off we go. Let's play and do an on-the-cuff spontaneous video, because that is what this is. Yeah, I know it is a review, or well, for me, I want it to be a review more than it is like I show you the game. Ah, I kind of forgot. You can have a rewinds like in a lot of games from the same creator. But the harder you set the difficulty, the less amount of rewinds you get. You can also, even on the most easy setting, now it's on unlimited at the moment, but you can also on easy make it, say, 5 rewinds, or 4, 3, 2, or 1. So it's 5 is the maximum amount you can select by hand, and after 5 comes unlimited. But well, in the previous races, you see that I don't even use the rewind. But now I was focusing on the chat more than I was on the driving. And so I thought, you know what, it's a nice chance to also show off the rewind function. What I like about the rewind function, like for instance, I do it now. I was on purposely stop steering. When I press Y again, you get a little bit more time before you can position your hands on the proper triggers again. So it has a bit of momentum. It's not like before, Zah, that immediately after you cancel the rewind, that you want to start from that point, then the race is starting immediately. And here you get like that a bit of a slowdown, and we go. In the beginning, I had to get used to it, because yeah, after playing Forza for so much, you are so used to that immediately reaction to that. And here that slowdown, yeah, I don't know, it gives you a bit of more relaxing time to get your hands back on the proper position. Yeah, too bad you cannot see it in the same quality as I can, but the black cores, like now by driving by night, and then you get to see the fireworks. They really pop out of the screen, man. So if you have a TV that has a high dynamic range and it's an OLED screen, or a screen where you at least get a nice black level so you don't see the backlight behind it, if you got a TV like that, man, those cores are really popping. I know I said it before, but it makes such an impact. Well, this is the final round. I will do the track next to this, and then I'll do my scoring bit. But wow. As a matter of fact, even without scores, the amount of fun that I'm having with the game, for me, this is the best racing game of this generation. And before this, it was Forza Horizon 4. It's still an amazing game, don't get me wrong. The freedom, the free roaming, and still the great graphics. But somehow this game gives me more fuzz. It's difficult to really explain, but... With Forza, if I got, for instance, I record video footage of that game, if I would do a review on Forza Horizon, then it was okay, I turn the game off, I do the video edit now, and no problem. But with this game, actually, I would have preferred to just continue playing and not do the video edit, but then it has no use doing the video. No, not rewinding, let's just go. Let's see what time that I get. I know I'm playing on easy now. Yeah, that is of course because I know that if I want to make a video, I know I want to talk, and when I'm talking, I'm not focusing as much as I need to when you're driving on the edge. But as you can see, I can still catch the car in its difficult moments, even if I'm too eager on the accelerator. Graphically, there's only one thing missing, and that is definitely in Forza Horizon on the Xbox One X, and that is when your lights are shining on a lamppost and behind that is a building. In Forza Horizon 4, you get to see the shadow that that light post casts. In this game, the light goes through everything. The public, street furniture, everything, it leaves no shadow. So, and that is the only thing that's removing a bit of the believability of what you are seeing. But since this is another simulation racer, but more close to arcade, I can just look through the fingers, well, that's a saying here in the Netherlands. I just can forgive them that. I mean, hey, the rest of the game is just awesome. I already did the hot qualifying, so let's go. She's talking. Oh, now she interrupts herself that she says sorry. Oh, that is nice. That's also what I like. That's the typical eye for detail, or in this case, eye for audio detail. Usually it just cuts away the chatting and then the race starts. Here they really respond on your impatient action by commenting on that. Yeah, steering and having these curve stones and accelerator, that's not a good combination. Before I forget, there's also a nemesis system. If you get the difficulty high enough, then the AI drivers, they remember if you bumped on them. For instance, like right now, I did a qualifying lap and I started at the front. But if I would have just skipped the qualifying, you start from the last place or somewhere in mid-range. And you have to pass the cars. And if you bump into one person too much, they're becoming your nemesis. In other words, they try to hunt you down, and when their chance is right, they bump you off the road. Also a very nice detail, even though it's not a simulation, and you are still not able to drive like a maniac, a music maniac, if you're driving on the higher levels. But what I like and really appreciate what they have done is that you've got so much options that you can change, that this game is enjoyable for pro drivers as well as beginners. Because when you have all the helping aids on, it's really like I'm pointing, I want the car to go to the left, I want that the car goes to the right. And of course, you still got the brake, otherwise you're crushing the car in the barriers. But there's no more, if you accelerate on curbstones, you don't have to get that kind of unstable action. You do not have to know that you have to lift off in a slippery corner, things like that. You don't have to deploy real racing tactics when you've got all the helping stuff on. And also sometimes you can see on the map a green dot, that's your teammate, and a red dot. And that is your kind of special opponent. If you beat him, you get some more points because you've reached one of the goals of the game. Very softly in the background you heard that I was driving past the speaker again, if the camera picked it up. So it's like the audience that is watching the race, they also get entertained by a voiceover. But other than that, the light doesn't leave a shadow behind, the effect itself is amazing. On some high gloss paint that you recently saw on the billboards, you get to see some more reflection than you get to see on darker shades of paint. Yes, this is the final lap and the finish across the line. Yes, as you can see, you get some teammate earnings by bumping in the side of the barriers. Yes, you have some costs as well. So this will, well, since I've bought the most expensive version of the game with all the add-ons, so you get a VIP bonus of 10%. So yeah, you can save up for that special car. I've already acquired me in a Ferrari. Let's continue. And as promised, I will do just one more track, if it's a city track. And then I'm going to my conclusion. Oh cool, my teammate was second place. So we did a nice job. Oh, I also forgot, during a race you have the D-pad. If you press the D-pad up, you can make your teammate, if he's behind you, attack the one in front of him. Or if he's also in second place and you put D-pad down, you can make him defend if somebody's coming up your rear or up his rear and he wants to pass. You can say that he must be a bit more aggressive. But if you play on a higher difficulty settings and, for instance, you have bumped in too much into your teammate, they'll be angry at you. Yes, they'd be better at driving because they want to pass you as well. But he won't obey your questions anymore. So when you use the D-pad after you bumped on him too much, it's like, then your pit crew says, it seems like your teammate is not responding. Yeah, he wasn't so happy with your behavior. Tuner car, that's also nice. And this is, no, this is not, oh, let's do this one. Why do I want to do this one? It's in San Francisco and it's with the Mini. This is a front-wheel drive car, a race version. So, in every corner, you have to let go of the gas, otherwise it will go straight ahead. Also, yes, we can do qualifying. I thought in this race you couldn't, but yes, you can. There are some races out there where you cannot qualify. You just have to go with the flow. And as you can see, I've got the racing line only in the corners, but just like Forza, and I guess also in Formula One, also from Codemasters, just like this game, you can also choose to have a full racing line or like this with the corners only, or fully switched off. If you memorize all the tracks, of course, it's much more fun to play without the racing line. With all those coloring papers in the air, it reminds me on the early 3D games when they started to promote 3D in the games. This game would have been awesome in 3D as well. Okay, let's see if I can interrupt the chatter again. Oops. Yeah, I like that. I've been told that the race is seconds away from start out or something like that. Since this is a front-wheel drive car, it doesn't respond too terrible if you go over the curbstones and you keep on hammering the accelerator. Let's do this on purpose here. No, as you can see, it gives a little bump, but other than that, it's not that you're spinning around and facing in the wrong direction. The reflections in the car are beautiful, but they are at a very low resolution. Let's pick up the curbstones. Yes, no problem. Clean section, good corner, thank you very much. Oh, this was not a good corner. I strayed away too far from the racing line. Break. What I also like is you got some point-to-point races. There was one point-to-point race, it took quite some time, it was cool to see. But most of it, say 99% or 98%, it's just circuit-based driving laps, either in a city or on a racing track. Final lap! If this was a Sega game, it would say final lap! With Outrun, with every checkpoint you have. Checkpoint! Checkpoint! So, Codemasters, if you want to imitate Sega, make an update for this game. Where you can get an audible checkpoint. I'll use some samples from Top Gear and Across the Line. Yeah, it's a mini, so with this chicane you can just go full throttle. Okay, I will make the game do a replay. And then on to, or did this, was this the first race? I don't know. Well, let's just replay. The video is long enough already as it is. And you can choose the camera angles and what car to follow. I'll just leave it on default. Well, as you can hear during the video, I'm very enthusiastic about the game. And as a matter of fact, I don't want to stop playing. That's a good sign. So only from a gameplay point of view, this game would have gotten a 10. But I have to be seriously, there are some things, I know, minor things, that takes away the believability. It looks so realistic, yet still having so much, like, almost cartoony-like color schemes, which I really like. But the omission of, even on Xbox One X hardware, that light doesn't cast a shadow, that is too bad. The pop-up of some shadows really in your face, if it's far away or halfway across the screen, I wouldn't have minded. Maybe I wouldn't even have noticed in the heat of the battle. But even the first time that I played this game, like, poop, there's the shadow. What the fuck is it? Oh, that was a shadow. That was ugly. But to me, it's like, too bad. That's a missed opportunity. I would have preferred that they would have removed the shadow instead of adding it in so late. But other than that, you have no popping of furniture, people, other road details, and even in the replay, it looks smooth and no strange things happening in here. Also, this game is supporting the Pro console, so the PlayStation 4 Pro and the Xbox One X. So I'm happy about that as well. So when you're having a new fangled 4K TV with high dynamic range, you're in for a treat. And I bet it will look awesome even on a normal TV. On a TV without high dynamic range, I mean. So in total, taking gameplay and everything added to each other, I would say this is definitely a 9.5. So yeah, Codemasters, I do prefer this game so much more than Formula One, because I'm more into the games where you can just select a car, you can tweak, but you are not obligated to. There are not too much rules that interrupt your race, like in Formula One, that you cannot swap engines too much, so you have to choose to drive it a slower thing. I know it's like in real life, and the race fans that follow Formula One would love that attention to detail. Me, I just want to pick a car and race and don't have to worry about, oh, can I fix my car? Because if I fix my car, I will have to move back a few places because I get a penalty. That's not something for me. This is more a racing game of my liking. Fast, smooth graphics, super gameplay, which you can tweak from beginner to pro. Well, before I forget, and this is also why I've taken a half point off, is there are actually not that many different backgrounds or tracks, so to speak, in this game. You get like a long version of a Formula One circuit, a short version, and you get some cities, and that's it. Even the previous grid game had more different backgrounds than this game. But compared to the old days, take for instance Daytona, Ridge Racer. Ridge Racer had one track and a longer version of that same track. And Daytona USA had three tracks. So compared to three tracks, this is of course more. But well, time doesn't stand still. And for the amount of money we pay, we can expect more. At least, I feel I've been given enough by this game. I hope you liked the video. And if you do, leave a thumbs up. If you like the channel and you haven't been here before, subscribe. I wish you all a nice day and see you in the next video.